those communities and to make it so that people, not only their first census will be the fact that they have and can normally for the possibility of the first access to businesses, helps education centers, healthcare, quality of life. Farmers need it. Some ways in the world we've established eating what was not what.
I know that's right.
Okay, good food is not what I want. Not that it is.
Which is a company that owns three rooftop clinics around the United Sunset. We're not losing it, we're there. I can tell you firsthand what I saw on both sides of the coin as a mom with six children, but I can also tell you the challenges we saw with telemedicine at the height of COVID. From a medical standpoint, it was imperative that we keep our older generation at home, not exposed. And in the height of the pandemic, we actually opened our Sunset location because our other two locations could not take the capacity. And so we became a large testing facility where you by no means want to mix your 80-year-old grandmother with 50, 70 people that were tested for COVID that were positive at that time. And so the challenges we definitely saw was not only the audio aspect of it, but also the video aspect where they just didn't have the connectivity. So I can tell you from a medical standpoint, I am super excited to see what this grant brings. Not only as a mom, you know, but from an education standpoint, but also from a medical standpoint. And so that definitely would make a difference in what is brought here in this area. So one of the things that we saw around the country and the senior experience was that seniors, for example, would have to live with a couple of places like a couple of libraries to have travel medicine, which meant that they were, the street was right there, they were talking at five people, so they don't have privacy, right? But have you seen how that might impact that person's willingness to actually seek medical care if they're in that kind of environment? Absolutely. And what you also see is, especially in St. Andrew Parish, I mean, some of those people are 35 miles from the nearest location of any medical service. And so what the other flip of that point is that a lot of times that generation is not as experienced with smartphones and those type of things. A lot of this generation still has home phones. And so what we saw is, how often do you hand a phone to your granddaughter and say, fix this, because you don't know what's wrong with it on the husband. And so it wasn't just that, it was also that aspect of being depending on smartphones and, you know, in the middle of seeing that, the internet goes out. And like you said also, the other aspect is you're crippled because we are electronic medical records. So when the internet's down, you're down. You don't have access to that for, you know, the allergies that you're giving the patient, electronically sent prescriptions, and it's a maybe telephone. Our telephone at all three of our locations is in that space. And so I can tell you from the medical standpoint and the mom standpoint, I am by far excited to see what this brings. What is the age range of your children? My baby is 11 and my oldest is 31. Okay. Yeah, so it's an interesting outfit. Do you work at all in terms of mental health as well? Because what we've been seeing is that you and I are in Parish County professional health that work in the month. I can say you're a physician. Thank you.
choose on how we are. The curriculum is technified, it's for science, DBT, social studies, already kids math, and you can do it. Google Classroom is like helping you up on for classes on the limits for the array. Edulacy can be for every single one of the tests for math.
So all of those you can access if you're a high school kid. And without it, you can't do them. Yeah, that's a big deal. Okay.
passengers asleep in the cake inside a van to get to the van. He would lay in there with the smell fence fire, silent, nothing to do over. Mickey lay there for the minute for a lot of food.
But the wires aren't also good enough.
It's glass.
So it would not.
And this is your constraint. It would show you the whales. It welds the glass together. And I did actually take a glass about 30 years ago. There's no machines like they get on with this. It would take about 20 minutes to do the least heat through one in 5 minutes. I can do it in 5 minutes. I'm a good slicer. I'm a good slicer every day, all day long. We'll be doing it in 30 seconds.
So this is the fabric.
Yeah. Yeah. This is the cable. This is a 96 full cable. It has 12 fibers in each one of those. And 3.5 feet. There you go. The size of the cable.
Right.
This is the best tool you have for fiber. This is really trying to get young people involved with this because their hands are not shaking, they have good eyes. It's real important. I think this is going to boom. This business is going to boom. There's nobody, they wouldn't get no education to do this. And it's pretty technical.